Now let us discuss about inverse of a function. How to find out inverse of a function? Here we have two models are there. So the first two examples are based on model 1, whereas the next two examples are based on model 2. First let us see the model 1. Let we have a function f from which maps from a to b. So a is the first set, b is the first set. E is a bijective function. We can calculate inverse of a function only when it is bijective function. We know what is bijective function. Bijective function means it should be 1 to 1 and on 2. So let we have a function f which maps from set A to set B is a bijective function. Then we can denote inverse with the help of f inverse. So f inverse from A to B means we have to map from B to A. So this is the definition here. So let we have a function f which maps from A to B, which is a bijective function. That means it is onto as well as 1 to 1 function. Then we can calculate inverse of a function by denoting with f inverse symbol which maps from B to A. Okay, so let us see this approach. Here, based on this definition, we are going to solve the first two examples. So here we have two sets, x and y, and we have a function. Okay, so let us see whether it is bijective function or not. If it is bijective, then only we can perform the calculation of the inverse. So here x elements are 1, 2, 3. This is nothing but x. This is nothing but y. Here we have function. So y elements are k, l, m. Okay. K, l, m. Okay. So 1 to k, we have some mapping. Next 2 to m, we have some mapping. Next 3 to l, we have some mapping. So first let us check whether it is bijective function or not. So what is bijective function? It should be 1 to 1 as well as onto. So what is 1 to 1 function? What is 1 to 1 function? Every distinct element of set X should have a distinct image of Y. Okay. Here 1 have a mapping K, 2 have a mapping M, 3 have a mapping L. So this is 1 to 1 function. We have one more property is there. Two elements in set X cannot have the same mapping in Y. Okay. So 1 and 2 are not mapped to the same element. 2 and 3 are not mapped to the same element. 3 and 1 are not mapped to the same element. Suppose if 1 and 2 are mapped to K, then we can say that it is not a 1 to 1 function. But here there is no such mapping. Okay. So this is a 1 to 1 function. As well as what is onto function? Every element of set B should have a mapping. So K is having some mapping. L have some mapping, M have some mapping. So this is onto function. So we can say that this is bijective function. If it is a bijective function, then we can calculate the inverse. So what is F inverse? F inverse means it maps from B to A. Here B means Y, A means X. Okay. What are Y elements? K, L, M. And what are X elements? 1, 2, 3. So for K, the mapping is 1. Okay. So just like that we can write. Next for L, the mapping is for L the mapping is 3. Okay. Next for M, the mapping is what? For M, the mapping is 2. Okay. So here what is the ordered pair? The reverse of the elements. So F inverse is equal to reverse. So 1 comma K means K comma 1. 2 comma M means M comma 2. 3 comma L means L comma 3. So in this way we can compute. Okay. Now let us see the second example. Okay. Second example is also based on the first model only. So first we need to check whether it is bijective or not. So here what is the function? Here function maps from A to B. So this is A, this is B. So what are the elements of A? 1, 2, 3. What are the elements of B? A, B, C, D. So here what are the mapping? 1 to A we have mapping. Next to 2 to B we have mapping. 3 to C we have mapping. Okay. For D there is no mapping. Okay. First let us check whether it is 1 to 1 or not. So what is 1 to 1? Distinct elements of set A are mapped to the distinct elements of set B. So 1 is mapped to A, 2 is mapped to B, 3 is mapped to C. And what is one more condition? Two elements in set A cannot be mapped to the same element of set B. So 1 and 2 are not mapped to the same element of set B. 2 and 3 are not mapped to the same element of set B. Likewise, 1 and 3 are not mapped to the same element of set B. So this is 1 to 1. Okay. And let us check whether it is onto function or not. What is onto function? For every element of set TB, there should be some mapping. But unfortunately for D, there is no mapping. If there is no mapping, then we can say that this is not onto. So this is not onto function. So we can say that this is not bijective function. If it is not a bijective function, then there is no need to compute the F inverse. We can calculate the inverse of a function only when it is bijective function. But this function is not a bijective function, so we can't compute F inverse. Now let us find the inverse of F of x is equal to x cube minus 2, okay? So in order to calculate inverse for these types of examples, we need to follow four steps. The first step is, first we have to replace F of x with y. So we have to replace F of x with y. And the second step is, we have to swap x and y. And the third step is, we have to solve the equation for y. And the fourth step is, replace y with f inverse of x. This f inverse of x is nothing but reverse of the function. So let us see the equation. Third example, example 3. F of x is equal to x cube minus 2. Okay. So what is the first step? Replace f of x with y. So in place of f of x, we have to write y. So y is equal to x cube minus 2. What is the second step? Swap x and y. So in place of x, here swapping means interchanging. In place of swap, let us use the variable interchange. We have to interchange x and y. That means in place of x, we have to write y. In place of y, we have to write x. In place of this y, write x. In place of this x, write y. So x is equal to y cube minus 2. Then we have to solve the equation for y. So that means y, we need to solve y. So we have to write as y cube is equal to x. If we move this minus 2 here, then we will get x plus 2. So y cube is equal to x plus 2. Then we can write y as y is equal to 3 root of x plus 2. And what is the last one? Replace y with f inverse of x. So we have to replace this y with f inverse of x. So f inverse of x is equal to 3 root of x plus 2. So this is the inverse of this function as x cube minus 2. So let us solve one more example so that if you have any doubts, then your doubts will get clarified. So for solving these types of examples, there is no need to check whether it is bijective or not. Why? Because those functions are already bijective functions. Simply we need to apply this algorithm. Okay. So f of x is equal to phi x minus 3 by 2x plus 1. So what is the first step? Replace f of x with y. So y is equal to phi x minus 3 by 2x plus 1. What is the second step? We need to interchange x and y. So in place of y, write x. In place of these x's, write y. So x is equal to 5y minus 3 by 2y plus 1. So 5y minus 3 by 2y plus 1. Now we have to compute it, solve the solution for y. So for that, let us move this one equation here. Then x into 2y plus 1 is equal to 5y minus 3. So if we multiply x with 2y plus 1, we will get 2xy plus x is equal to 5y minus 3. Here we need to compute for y. Okay. So let us move fy to left hand side and move x towards the right hand side. So then we will get 2xy minus 5y is equal to minus 3. If we move x towards this side, minus x. Here y, this y is common. So we can common y. So what are the remaining terms? 2x minus 5 is equal to minus 3 minus x. Okay. And from this we will get y is equal to minus 3 minus x by 2x minus 5. So here we solve the equation for y. And what is the last step? Replace y with f inverse of x. So f inverse of x is equal to minus 3 minus x by 2x minus 5. Okay. So this is nothing but f inverse for this problem. Okay. Likewise, we can solve inverse of a function very, very easily.